Hello everyone, today we are going to discuss about transportation problem. In previous classes we are discussing about the simplex method. This is our second unit, transportation problem. In this unit we are going to learn the transportation solutions. These solutions are two types. One is the infeasible solution, initial basic feasible solution, and another one is optimal solution. And here we have the two types of transportation problems. One is the balanced transportation problem and another one is the unbalanced transportation problem. And here we have the degeneracy assignment problems. Those we are going to solve this transportation problem. Then coming to the another one, here we have the sequencing. Here we are going to learn into the flowchart sequencing, n jobs, 2 missions, n job, 3 missions, m jobs, n missions we are going to discuss in this unit. Here the main aim of this unit is we are going to minimize the cost. Why? Because every production industry, every management, they think over cost minimization for getting the maximum profit. In previous cases, we have considered the whole profit, maximization of the profit we considered. Here, in this case, we are going to consider the minimization of the cost. Here, the unit itself, transportation, here we are going to transfer the commodity from one supply station to another demand station. The main motive of this is to minimize the cost. Okay, next, coming to the transportation problem. So what is transportation problem? Here the transportation problem is a special type of linear programming problem. Here the main objective is to minimize the cost. Okay, it is difficult to solve by the simplex method. Here we have number of sources and number of origins we have. We have to transport the commodity from one supply station to another demand station based on the demand. Here we have to consider the unit cost and unit supply we have to consider. Okay. Next, coming to the transportation problem. Here the problem is having the skeleton we have the Cij. Here what does it mean? Cij means the unit cost. Transportation unit cost and Xij, it is the number of units transported we are taken. And here we have the source means, what is the source? Source is called as the supply station and destination is called as the demand station. Here we have the relation between the supply and demand. Okay, each source is having one certain supply. It means for example, if we take any one manufacturing industry, if suppose we are taking pen manufacturing. In the pen manufacturing industry, they have number of workstations to fabricate the pens. After completion of the fabrication, they send it to the market by various routes, by various transportation applications, by various transportation methodologies. They are applied and they transport the final finished goods to the market. Okay, based on the minimal cost. Okay, here coming to this. It is a network representation of the transportation problem. Here the sources and here the destinations. Here for example, we have taken the example. Okay, we are selling the pens in a market. Here we have a total n supply station. Here supply station 1, supply station 2, supply station 3. Okay, these three are the product manufacturers, or these three are the godowns, or these three are the warehouses we are taken. Finally, these are also called as the supply stations. Okay, here we have a supply station we have, and here we have the destinations. Here we have various demand centers we have, or otherwise it is also called as the marketplace. Okay, or otherwise it is also called as the customers. Okay, if it is a manufacturer, it is a customer. If it is a supply, it is a demand station. Like that we are taken. Okay, coming to the first supply station, here suppose we have 10 pens here, we have to supply these 10 pens to n number of demand stations by the various routes. Simply we are taking the routes. For example, here the salesman is here, or the product is here. We are going to sell this product, or we are going to supply this product to various demand stations here to here. Okay, we have to supply this product to this number of stations. Here we have to identify the routes. Okay, coming to the first route, here we have one route, and here we have another route, and here we have another route. First we have to choose the right way. It means which one is the nearest to us, or which one is the available with minimal cost, we have to check. For example, if we take 10 rupees of cost for taking this supply to here to here, or 15 rupees here to here, or 5 rupees here to here, we are having the supply, we are having the unit cost of supply we have. In these cases, which route is the better? Simply we take the 5 rupees, this route is we are choosing first. Okay, like that we have to choose the way. Okay, from supply station to demand station. These are the routes. Okay, these routes means here number of units transferred through this route with cost. Okay, with unit cost. Nice. Here the general mathematical model of a transportation problem. In a linear programming problem, what we have? In a linear programming problem, the standard form is there. There we have the standard form. It means the objective function is required, constraints are required. Okay. Here coming to this, here the constraints are different. Here there is no availability and requirement. Here we are choosing the supply and demand constraints. Okay. In LPP, we are choosing requirement and availability as a constraints. Here coming to this mathematical formulation, minimize. Object function is minimize. Why? Because here we are minimizing the cost. Which cost we are minimizing? Transportation cost we are minimizing. That's why we are choosing the object function is minimize. Xij, Aij. Here what is the Xij? Xij is the unit cost. Sorry, unit quantity. How many units we are supplying, that is called as Xij. Okay, then Aij is called as the availability of commodity. How much units are available with us? So that is called as the commodity availability in the origin. Okay, next, here coming to the constraints. Here what is the Xij? Xij is quantity transported from origin to destination. It means quantity of availability. A means commodity availability. Next, BA means needed. It means it is supply. AI is the supply and BAJ is the demand we are taken. And XIJ is the number of units available with us. Okay. Number of units available with us. We are taken. These are the constraints. This is the standard form of the transportation problem. Okay. Here what we have to remember? We have to remember the object function. That object function is minimization type. It is always in minimization type. Here, why we are taking minimization? Here we are considering the transportation cost is the object function. What is the goal of the transportation cost? We have to minimize the transportation cost. So that's why we are taking the transportation cost is the object function and it is always minimal. Okay, minimum cost we have considered here for object function. Coming to the constraints, here the constraints are supply and demand. These are the constraints. Okay. Next, coming to the simplex form tabular form of the transportation problem. This is the tabular column of the transportation problem. Here we have taken a first column. We have taken the sources or supplies. We have taken supplies, sources. We have taken. Or otherwise, these are also called as the warehouses. Or otherwise, these are also called as the company outlets. Okay, are also called as markets. Sometimes we are calling markets. Okay, if suppose if we take source is a warehouse, where we are sending? We are sending warehouse to market. If suppose we are taking the company, where we are sending company to market. If suppose company market is a source, we are sending product to customer from the market. Like that, we have to take the source. Okay, here the destinations are there. Destinations means various routes, various demand stations. For example, if we are in some X place, we are going to transfer the product from X place to Y place. Here we have some various destination centers we have. Okay, various places we have in between these two. Okay, those are all we are taken here. These destinations 1 to M we are taken here. Here C11 means C11, C12, C13. It is also called as Cij. This Cij is called as the unit cost. Transportation unit cost. Okay. Next, X11, X12, X13 is there. Xij is called as number of units availability or number of units transferred. number of units transferred. Okay, and A1, A2, A3 are, these are the commodity supply, availability we have, availability, okay, supply, number of products we have, availability. Next, BAJ is called as demand, the requirement, this is the requirement, this is the availability, okay. This is a table form of transportation problem. Coming to the transportation problem into a LPP, we are converting the transportation problem into the linear programming model. Here the minimization, we have taken the object function minimization. Why? Because it is a cost, we are going to optimize the cost, we are going to minimize the cost, that's the reason we are taking the object function is minimization type. And here we are taking the 10x1, 7x2, 8x3, these are all cost units, okay, based on the destinations, based on the sources, based on the traveling path, we are choosing this object function. Okay, next, coming to the subjective constraints, here simply we are taking the supply constraints and demand constraints we are taken. Here no need to take any less than or equal to type, and there is no need to take any greater than or equal to type. Simply we are taken the equality we are taken here, and here no need to convert this form into the inequality and equality. Directly it is available with equality. Here no need to add surplus variables, slack variables, artificial variables, whatever it may be. Okay. Here constraints is only, here we have two types of constraints. One is the supply constraint and another one is the demand constraint. Here how we get this x1, 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 okay, in the table column you see here x11, x12, these are all there. Okay, at first source we have n number of destinations, those are all coming as first constraint, constraint 1. This is constraint 2, second constraint, this is third constraint. Like that, this is nth constraint. Okay, here we have taken x11, x12, x13. These are the constraints. These are the supply constraints. Let's come to the demand constraint here. x11, x12, x31, these are the demand constraints. Total we are getting two constraints. One is supply constraint and another one is demand constraint. Each constraint we have number of linear equations. If suppose from this case we have taken supply is n, here from this we are getting m constraints, m supply constraints we are obtained. Next coming to this, n number of constraints we are obtained from this table. Okay, see this, x11, x12, x13 is equal to 45, this is a supply constraint. Next x11, x21, x31 is equal to 25, this is demand constraint. In a tabular column, we have rows and columns is there. Okay. Those column values are, we are taken as supply constraint. Okay, these are all the supply constraints. Next, coming to the row constraints, this is the supply constraint. Coming to the column wise, those column constraints are called as demand constraints. Okay. Demand constraint. Here I taken dash and question mark. Dash indicates the supply and question mark indicates the demand. Okay, here we have taken two types of constraints we have taken here. Okay, next coming to the transportation problem formulated as we have taken for simplex method. For example, if we take, if we are going to solve this problem by the help of simplex method, means what is the rule for solving the simplex method? We have to add the slack variables and surplus variables. Here in the transportation problem, we have already it is a equality type. So, simply we are adding the artificial variables to solving the transportation problem by the help of simplex method. Here the transportation problem we are solving by applying the various methods. Here we have two types of solutions. One is initial basic feasible solution and another one is optimal solution. Other than those two conditions, we may go for the simplex method to solve this problem. Okay, but most cases we are using those two cases to solving this problem. Here we are not using simplex method to solve this transportation problem. If they ask solve the transportation problem by the simplex method, we have to convert this this transportation problem into a simplex form. Okay, what is the simplex form? If the constraint is a less than or equal to type, we have to add the slack variables. If the constraint is a greater than or equal to type, we have to add the surplus slack variables and artificial variables. If the constraint is a equal to type, we have to take the artificial variables. Here the transportation problem, it is always in equal to them. So simply we have taken the artificial variables to solve this transportation problems. Okay. Then after adding the artificial variables, again we have to take the objective function. We have to rewrite the object function with help of the artificial variables. This is the standard form of transportation problem by solving the simplex method. Okay. Next, coming to the applications of transportation problem. Here the applications of transportation problem. What is the main application? What is the main agenda of this transportation problem? We have to transport the commodity with a minimum cost. We are going to ship the products from one station to another station with a minimal cost. Okay, minimize the shipping cost, one is. The second one is determine the lowest cost locations. If suppose if we have the various stations, various destinations, if we have, for example, here the product is here, the demand is here. Okay, and number of stations are there. We have various paths to supply this demand, to supply this product to the destination. Okay, we have to calculate this distance as well as cost of the transportation. We have to calculate for every distance, for every route. After getting the calculation, after getting the value, we have to choose the minimal value. Which route is best and which one is takes less time and minimum cost. So that is we have to determine the low cost location. Next, find minimum cost production schedule. We have to schedule the transportation, because here we have the product and we have the three destinations. Which route is taking less time to transport the commodity? Those we have to take and we have to minimize that schedule. Okay. Next, military distribution system. Military distribution is military operations. They are transporting vehicles from one border to another border based on the need. Okay. At the time we are going to allocate the. At the time we are going to plan the transportation based on these cases. Okay. Next, coming to the transportation type problem. Okay. Here we have two types of transportation problems. One is balanced transportation problem and another one is unbalanced transportation problem. Coming to the balanced transportation problem, it is also called as the rim condition. Okay, balanced transportation problem means here we have the supply stations, sources we have, and each source we have some X supplies, and destinations we have, each destination we have some demand, the demand also we have some XY demands we have. Based on the supply and demand, we have to equal. Okay. If suppose we have 3x supply, demand also required 3y. Otherwise, if the demand is more and the supply is less, means it is an unbalanced transportation problem. Here the demand is equal to supply, or supply is equal to demand, the problem is called as balanced transportation problem. Okay. Balanced transportation problem. Next. Coming to the phases of transportation problem. Here we have a number of phases. First phase is obtain the initial basic feasible solution. Here before we are going to discuss this, we are going to the simplex method. Then we are calculating the initial basic feasible solution. How we are calculating the initial basic feasible solution in simplex method? In that first we are identifying the basic variables. Then we are identifying the non-basic variables. Then we are taking the non-basic variable value is 0. And we are substituting the non-basic variable values into the linear equations. Then we obtain the basic feasible solution. Okay. But here it is different. Here we have three methods to obtain the initial basic feasible solutions. One is the northwest corner method. And another one is the least cost entry method. It is also called as matrix minimum method. And third one is the Vogel's approximation method. It is also called as penalty method. Okay. Penalty method. Here coming to the northwest corner method. In this northwest corner method, we are allocating the resources at top corner. If suppose, for example, we have the 3x3 column, 3x3 table form. In northwest corner, we are assigning the commodity at topmost corner. This is called as the northwest corner method. Coming to the minimax or matrix mini or least cost entry method or LCM method, here we are allocating the resources at minimal value. If suppose, for example, we have the commodities 2, 3, 4, 1, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 like this. We are identifying the minimum cost. These are the cost values. We are identifying the minimum cost and we are taking the transportation in this particular path. That is called as the least cost entry method. Next, coming to Huygens approximation method. Here, before we are going to solve the Huygens approximation method, we are going to calculate the penalties. Like that, each row we have different costs. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. In between two least costs, we have to take the penalty. For example, if coming to this first row here, we have the two least costs. One is 1 rupee and second one is 2 rupees. So, in between these two, we have to calculate the penalty. 2 minus 1 is 1 penalty. Like that, we are going to calculate the penalties for each row and each column. Based on that, we are going to calculate the initial basic feasible solution. Okay. Next, phase 2. Obtains the optimal basic solution. Here we have the two types. One is stepping stone method and another one is modified distribution method. It is also called as MODI method. Okay. Here in this stepping stone method, we have to take the loops. Okay. We have to take the loops. In the loop, it must enter with the allocated cell and it must close with allocated cell itself. Okay. Like that, we are going to draw the loops, then we are going to solve the optimal solution. Coming to the modified distribution method, here we are calculating the unit cost for each cell, each allocated and allocated by the help of this formula. Okay, demand plus supply is equal to unit cost we are taken. Based on that, we are going to calculate the modified distribution method. Next, coming to the optimal solution, after completion of the initial basic feasible solution, we have to check the optimality. Whether the problem is reached the optimality or not. By the help of the formula is M plus N minus 1. Here M is number of rows or supplies. N is number of demands or columns minus 1. After getting this, we are getting the allocated value. Here we are allocating some units. Okay. After calculating that, we have to get the allocation value. Otherwise, it doesn't reach the optimality. Again, we are going to add the dummy rows and dummy columns. We have to recheck the degeneracy. Then we are coming to the optimality. Then only after reaching the optimality, we are going to solve the problem with the help of stepping stone method and modified distribution method. That is first one. Next, coming to the transportation algorithm. Okay. Here, the algorithm is first step. We are formulating the problem and arrange the data into the matrix form. Okay. In previous cases, simplex or graphical method, there is no need to convert any mathematical model into the matrix form. But here we have to convert the given model into matrix form. Here, how we are converting the given model into matrix form? Here, very simple way. It means simple. We have constraints is there, supply constraint and demand constraint. Okay, first we are taking the supply constraint. Okay, then if suppose we have three linear equations. Those three supply units we are writing here, x, y, z like this, x, y, z. Okay, after here right hand side value is there, supply value. Those values we have to take here, 1, 2, 3. And similarly demand constraint we are taken and those values we have to take here. Okay, like this we are going to write into a matrix form. Next, obtain the initial basic feasible solution. The initial basic feasible solution is obtained based on the three methods. One is northwest corner method and another one is least cost entry method. Third one is VAMP method or penalty method. Huygens approximation method or penalty method. After calculating the initial basic feasible solution, we have to check the optimality by using the formula M plus N minus 1 is equal to allocations. Okay, if it satisfies, we are going to the optimality. Otherwise, again, we are going to resolve the degeneracy. Okay. Next, coming to the step 3, test the initial solution for optimality or not. We test the basic feasible solution for its optimality either by MODI method or stepping stone method. It means after identifying the M plus N minus 1 is equal to allocations, after getting this, we are going to solve the problem by the help of modified distribution method or MODI method by our stepping stone method. If coming to the MODI method, again we are going to calculate the values of unallocated cells and allocated cells and we are checking the solution. Then finally updating the solution. Okay.
Next, coming to the summary, what we discussed here, we discussed about the transportation problem. What is the transportation problem? Here we are transferring the commodity from one station to another station by taking the cost resource. By taking the cost resource, it means we are minimizing the cost, or we are optimizing the time, or we are optimizing the process. It means we are taking the minimum cost we are taking. Next, step 2, we are taking the matrix form. How to write the matrix form? How to write a matrix form we are discussing here. From the LPP, we are converting that LPP into the matrix form. Here we are taking. At the time of conversion, we have to identify the supply constraints and demand constraints. Okay, next. Here we are discussing initial basic feasible solution. Here initial basic feasible solution is we are having three methods to obtain the initial basic feasible solution. One is northwest corner method, least cost entry method, Vogel's approximation method, or it is also called as penalty method. Okay, after getting this, we have to check the condition n plus n minus 1. Here what is the m? Number of rows, number of columns, minus 1 is equal to allocations. Okay, next, fifth one, we are discussing about the optimal solution. Here we are calculating the optimal solution by using two methods. One is stepping stone method and another one is modified distribution method. It is also called as MODI method. Okay, this is our today's lecture. Thank you.